How you doing? Well, I had a break. I'm back. Washed my hands. Changed my shirt. And I'm ready to get back to it. So now I cleaned the floor and got all this cleaned up. Now I can work on getting my bench back by getting all this stuff out of here and organized. So that's what you're gonna see today. The first thing that I gotta do is I'm gonna get the printers over here, which I don't know if you can see. Let me move you. These printers that we stacked up earlier are going to be stacked up over here. Now, it's not raining right now, and it's probably going to start clearing off, but Claudette, Tropical Storm Claudette, who went through Alabama and wound up, there was a really bad accident on I-65, I think, and killed 9 children. It's horrific. So, anyway, I think it's going to start clearing up now, but it was just pouring about 5 minutes ago, just absolutely coming down. So there's no way I'm going to get out in that and work. Now, I don't mind taking a walk in that. That's awesome. Yeah, Johnny, you were talking about that. Getting out in the rain. Yeah, this is the kind of warm rain that's just cool to walk around in. But I'm not going to get out there and work in it. It makes it messy and soupy. So, anyway, I'm going to set you up. And I'm going to get started. I think that should be good. This is a dot matrix printer. I think I've shown this on an update before where I got it. But yeah, some older lady was getting rid of it, so I brought it home for my boys to see, and we're gonna open it up together this summer and see what's inside and have fun seeing what old technology and engineering was. Back in my day. And it absolutely 100% does not work. My microwave wall or extension over here. Cool. Oh, I got another. I got a laser printer over here, believe it or not. Ugh, I'm gonna put this computer here. Got this PC at some point. Around the same time that I got the dot matrix. Not for the same. Las Vegas. I don't drink, but I thought that was fun. I went to Las Vegas a couple years ago. If Caroline, if you're watching, I know you're jealous, but visited my brother in Utah, and we flew in and out of Las Vegas. So we got to experience the strip a little bit. Not stripping wire, but actual scantily clad women with big boa fans on their head. No, we really didn't do any of that. We only stayed a couple nights and we went to the casino and I won $21 and Brian lost his $20 bill or $50 bill or whatever he had when he did his, I don't know what he did. Jack Black Gelson. Anyway, I always say things backwards. But yeah, it was a fun time. And the boys, played in the pool and whatnot. But seeing the national parks out there was just incredible. If you ever get to go to the Grand Canyon, believe me, it's so gorgeous. Anyway, back to work. And this bath thing I'll sell or donate if it doesn't sell. Then I got a bin. I put this up here for now. Let's move this out. It's a big old chunk. This is for another day, another video, but I'll take the stuff that's not boards out of it. It's a whole box of boards, and I need to sort them all, but not today. I promise promise I might do a video for you on that. If you want to, let me know. Just comment below. Aluminum. My magnet is over there. I think this is stainless. Ends off of these. This though has already got cut up. Storm is just on top of humidity that we normally get. Tropical storms, like, you know, they're just full of moisture. That's all it is a wind and moisture event, and it's like 100% humidity and only 75, which if it was dry, that would be lovely weather, but not over here. on the tool bench. Another old alarm clock. I didn't see this because it was buried under everything. I could have done this on my video that I posted, but probably would have made the video really long, so just pretend that you know all of that.
Thank you. This is what we call the floor mat boogie. I'd like to thank Matt from Mad Matt's bucket list for suggesting this idea of putting a magnet on a string for picking up magnetic things off the floor so I don't have to bend over. Thank you so much, Matt.
Mid-grade boards.
eighth grade boards. Well, guys, I think we're gonna have to have a part three, because it's taking a long time. I mean, I work slower than a lot of people because of all my stuff, but I won't keep talking about that. But just wanted to have you come along on my journey of cleaning this darn garage up. And hopefully we can get some stuff done in the next month, because the boys go back to school at the end of July. Oh my gosh, school already. I don't want to think about it. Anyway, so until the next time, which will probably be for me tomorrow. I don't know how long it's going to take me to upload all these videos, but within the next week you'll probably be seeing this. Claudette came through. It's Tuesday, June 22nd. So, but until then, be kind, and I hope you enjoyed this video. Give me a like, and please subscribe. It means a lot to me that you want to see my videos. You know, if you don't, then, you know, there's no reason you need to even be watching. But if you do enjoy them and you want to be a part of my community and have me a part of your community, then subscribe, because it helps all around. I don't like to talk about algorithms and stuff. I'm not a math person. I don't care much about all of that stuff, except for the fact that I'd like to get enough subscribers so that I can do community posts with pictures during the week, and also that I can put up a wish list, Amazon wish list, and a tip jar, so that you can help out if you so desire. So anyway, there we go. See you next time. Bye.